yummy. I'll tell ya, J-E-S-U-S. Yes, he is the king of me. He is the king of the universe, the jungle and the sea. Ba 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 ba. He is the king of the universe, the jungle and the sea. Ba 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 ba.
Stand firm. Sean. I live in Jamaica. Today's song is Song of Freedom.
Medicinal plant. Just come a little bit closer so that you can see which plant I'm referring to. How many of you know this plant? Well, some of you have guessed right. This is called an aloe vera plant. So I just cut up a leaf from this plant. It's right here. So this is the way an aloe vera plant looks inside. So I just cut a piece from there. So it's got a lot of gel inside. Now this aloe vera plant has many uses. It helps fight against bacteria, it helps fight against inflammation, infections, and it's also an antiseptic. So I'll give you the uses that of aloe vera for us human beings. So the first use of aloe vera is it can be used to kill stomach bacteria. Bacteria can cause a lot of diseases to the body. So if aloe vera is drunk, you could do this by getting two tablespoons like this, put in a cup of water of the aloe vera juice. And when you drink this juice, if you do it about twice a day, it could help kill bacteria in the stomach. Then also orally, it can be used as a mouthwash. So you basically make a solution and use it to rinse your mouth. To be able to kill some bacteria in your mouth and also prevent certain diseases. That's why you realize that there's a lot of toothpaste these days that is made using aloe vera. Also, aloe vera can be drunk even in smoothies. So you can put aloe vera juice and mix it with other juices, because aloe vera, by the way, is quite bitter. So I wouldn't actually recommend it for the very small kids, but it's a very good killer bacteria, but it is quite bitter. So the second use of aloe vera is for our skin. Now, aloe vera can be used to for acne. So you could get a leaf like that. And just basically rub it onto your face or wherever you have this acne. So after it dries off, you can then rinse it with water. You can do this twice a day and it will help with your acne. And in case you suffer allergies, maybe try it on a small area of your skin first, then make sure you don't react, then you can use it as a daily use. And it's also pretty good for wrinkles, so you could tell your grandparents about it so that it can help tighten up their skin. And another very important use for the skin is for burns. So when the children or you have any minor burns, you could get this aloe vera juice and also rub it onto the area where you've got your minor burns. It helps kill the bacteria in that area and actually helps the wound heal much, much faster. Then the third juice I'm going to discuss is for the hair. So you could get this aloe vera juice as well, put it in your hair. It is used to fight against dandruff, and it's also used to help hair grow and keep it thick. So those are the three main uses for human beings that I'd love to discuss to you with relation to aloe vera. But aloe vera is very important because it can also be used in plants, in animals. Those who keep village chickens, some of you might be aware, it can be used as well to kill diseases in chickens. So it's used as an antibiotic. You can put it in the water feeders and you have your chickens drink it and they will be quite healthy. So thank you for joining us today. Have a happy Sabbath. Goodbye.
Good morning, children. And good morning, mommies and daddies, and happy Sabbath to you all. My name is Uncle Joye, and I'm going to be giving you the mission story for today. Our mission story today comes from a very, very far off country called India. Do we all know where India is? Mommies, daddies, children, do we know where India is? Don't worry. I will show you where India is. So you see right over here, we have Africa. This is where Zambia is. And if you go over the Indian Ocean, up to there, that red little thing dot there, that's where India is, okay? That is where our mission story is coming from today. And it's about a boy whose name is called Karthik, okay? Karthik is an 11-year-old boy in India. And I have a picture of him here. Can you all see him? Yes, that is Karthik, okay? The title of our mission story today is called Worship Mischief. You know what mischief is? Does anybody know what mischief is? When you're misbehaving? Yes, that's mischief. When you're doing funny, funny things? That's mischief. Now, our mission story is about doing funny things, okay? Doing mischief during prayer time, okay? So we're told that this boy, Karthik, used to go to an Adventist school, okay? Like King's Highway, okay? An Adventist school, all right? And he was 11 years old. Now, during prayer time, okay, when the teacher was speaking in front, the teacher said to the children that Jesus is the true God, okay? That Jesus was what? The true God. And Karthik, you know, started whispering to his friends, you know what? He's not the true God. Jesus is not the true God. You know, while the teacher was talking, then the teacher noticed, Karthik, what are you doing? What are you saying? He got quiet because you're scared. Because what used to happen is when you make noise and you do mischief or funny things during worship time at that school, then they would not give you any breakfast. And everybody wanted to have that delicious breakfast that they would have. And you know what they would have for breakfast? No, not cornflakes, but very nice, healthy porridge. And everybody wanted the delicious porridge. So when the teacher asked to say, who's that interrupting? Everyone was quiet. It was quiet. The teacher asked Karthik, Karthik, what did you say? He was scared. He was quiet. And then she turned to his friend and said, "What did Karthik say?" And the friend said, "What do I do here?" The friend said to the teacher, "Teacher, Karthik said that Jesus is not the true God." And then the teacher looked at him and just continued preaching, okay? And when they finished their devotion, the teacher just continued preaching. Then they finished their devotion and they went away. And when they went away, they made sure that Karthik didn't have breakfast that particular morning. Unfortunately, even the days that came afterwards, Karthik continued to disturb the prayers, you know? And every time he did that, they didn't give him any breakfast at all. All right? No breakfast for Karthik. He went hungry because he was misbehaving. However, one Sabbath morning during a very nice presentation, you know, he heard the preacher preach very strongly and say that Jesus loves everybody and Jesus was going to help you overcome all the mistakes and help you become good children. Okay, and then Karthik believed, you know, he believed the word of God and started reading the Bible and praying. Now, unfortunately, the moment he started to do that, bad things started to happen to him. When he was playing in the field, he fell and then he broke his chin. Then they took him to the hospital, you know, started thinking, "Ish, why are bad things happening to me? Anyway, let me get better." When he got better, he had another accident happened to him. He broke both his legs. They had to take him to the hospital again. After that, again, he got sick. They had to do a hernia operation on him. You know, then he started to think, maybe these things are happening to me because I'm praying to this God of theirs. When the term finished, he told his parents to say, "You know what? I don't want to go back to that Christian school." You see, where he came from was about 40 kilometers away from the school. And his parents took him there because they wanted him to learn some English. You see, in India, most of the people there are not Christians. They speak Hindu and most of them don't even speak English. They don't teach English. But his parents took him there so that he could learn English. And before he went, he said that he would never go back to that school. But the teacher told him to say, "You know what? I would like you to come back to this school even next term." Okay? And when the term came, he decided to give Jesus a second chance. And he went back to that school and he continued praying and believed that Jesus was going to protect him. Why do we think bad things happen to hernia children, parents, mommies and daddies? Sometimes bad things do happen, but we must always believe that Jesus will always take care of us and Jesus is the true God. Thank you very much, children, and make sure that when you're having worship and prayer, you should always behave and not do any mischief, okay? See you next Sabbath. Happy Sabbath and be very good children. God bless you all.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Mitchell Hamsambo, and I'm going to present to you a story entitled The Lost Sheep.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Hamsambo, and I'm going to present to you the memory verse. The memory verse is Matthew chapter 28, verse 20. Says, Jesus says, "You can be sure that I will always be with you."
Have you ever been lost in a mall or a park when you went with your parents, but now you don't know where they are? Did you cry? Were you afraid? If you are afraid, you'll be like this sheep in the story I'm about to tell. The story is entitled The Lost Sheep. Once there was a man who had 100 sheep. He took care of his sheep. Every day he took them to green grassy fields where there was enough for them to eat. And also every day he took them to cool, clean water where they could drink enough. Every day he chased wild animals which would try to attack the sheep. Every day before going to bed, he would count them 1 up to 100. He loved the sheep and the sheep loved him. But one day worry came onto his face. Something was definitely wrong. He counted his sheep again. He found that there were only 99 and one was missing. Just like that, he went to look for it. He put all the 99 together so they should not get lost and went to look for it. He did not tell himself his words. "It is in the night. I will hate myself. I'm tired. I will go tomorrow. My legs are paining. I'm hungry. Instead, he just went and looked for it out of all his worry for just a sheep. Some of us cannot do that. After that, he started searching and searching for the sheep. He hit himself on stones and scratched himself on many things. But after looking and looking, he heard the sheep crying. He knew that this is my sheep now. He followed it as if it was crying closer and closer. Then he found it in a prickly bush. He removed it gently and put it on his shoulders. He did not think how heavy the sheep is. He was very happy that he found the sheep. And this story teaches us that Jesus is always with us. We should not be afraid, even though we are lost or anything, because Jesus is always with us. Thank you.
Welcome back, boys and girls. It's time for activity. Are you excited about activity?
Yes.
Okay, so activity today will be from the story that we learned. Do you remember the story we learned today?
Yes.
What was it about?
The lost sheep.
That's good. And what lesson did you learn from the lost sheep story?
That wherever you are lost, you shouldn't be afraid because God is with you.
Great, that's awesome. So today from the kindergarten class, we're going to do an activity where we're going to first color our, what's this?
A door hanger.
Great, so you've got your door hanger here, and I have my door hanger here. What is a door hanger used for?
For hanging on the doors.
Okay, so a door hanger is used to relay different messages. So today our door hanger says, Jesus is always with me. So we can start by coloring. What color do you want to color your hanger?
Red.
Good. So I'm going to color my door hanger color red. So you can give this door hanger to your friends, to your mommies, to your daddies, just to remind them that Jesus is with us all the time. So, Manuel, who are you going to give your door hanger to?
My brother.
Okay, that's nice. I'll wait for you to finish coloring. I have a very nice red door hanger. I'm going to give it to my friend. Let's see. Lift it up. Wow, Maluba has a purple door hanger that she's going to give her brother. Then we'll do another activity today. And the second activity we have is for the baby class, and we are going to make a sheep. Do you remember what happened to today's sheep in the story?
Mm-hmm.
What happened to it?
It got lost in a prickly bush.
Okay, that's lovely. So today we are going to make the lost sheep, the sheep that got lost in the bush. And our memory text for today is Luke 15 verse 6, and it says, "Be happy because I have found my lost sheep." So what do we need today to do our activity?
We need a marker.
Good. We need a marker for our verse.
And cotton wool.
Yes, we need cotton wool to make the fur on our sheep. Because actually this cotton wool that mommy uses to clean your wounds is actually from sheep. Then what else do we need?
A paper.
A paper and glue. We're going to use this glue to stick our cotton onto the paper. So, mommies and daddies, help the children do this. I'll need your finger. We're going to color your finger black. So, mommies and daddies, you could use a marker or an ink pad. So you can use an ink pad, you press your child's finger on an ink pad, or color your child's finger with a black marker like I'm doing now. And stick it onto the paper. So this is the head of our sheep. So we're gonna turn your paper like this. I'll also color my finger. And make the head of my sheep. Then the next thing we're going to do is get glue. And we put glue to make the body of our sheep. There you go. So you can start from here and put glue there. Yes. So I'll get my cotton. Let me help you here.
Everywhere.
Yes, everywhere. To make the body of the sheep, we close our glue and we stick. Put it in small pieces like this and we stick on the glue. This is lovely. Nice. Then what are we going to do now? We'll draw the legs of our sheep. So I'll draw my legs here. And my sheep's head. One eye. You can draw the legs facing this way. Four legs. Good. Nice. Okay. Then now we can write the memory verse and your name. You can write your name at the bottom. Wow. I'll just write the verse for you. Do you remember the verse? It says, be happy because I have found my lost sheep. And it's coming from Luke 15:6.
I have found my lost sheep.
Okay, wow. You show your friends your lost sheep? Wow, it looks so beautiful. Thank you, boys and girls, for joining us. I hope you have a lovely Sabbath. We are done with our activity for today. Bye.
Bye. Bye, my friends.
Sabbath, my friends. Welcome to primary class. Thank you for joining us yet again for another Sabbath. I know we've been doing it for a very long time, but boys and girls, we are almost there. Some of us have started going to church, and thank you for those of you that come to church and that also watch when you get home. Now, boys and girls, before we get into our lesson, shall we close our eyes and pray? Dear Jesus, thank you for being with us. Thank you for protecting us throughout the week. Thank you for being with us even as we go to school and leave the house, even in the time of the pandemic, Lord. Lord, I now just want to ask and pray that you may continue to heal the earth, continue to heal everyone that has the coronavirus. May we get back to church and be worshiping you at church as soon as possible, Lord. Thank you for everything you do for us, Lord. We just want to ask and pray now that you may be with us as we go into your lesson. Open up our hearts and our minds to your word. Amen. Boys and girls, it's now time for us to do our favorite part of Sabbath school. One of our favorite parts. It's now time for us to go into Sabbath school. And guess what? The songs were selected by your friends. Yes. So if you want to select songs for Sabbath school, what you can do is tell your mommy and daddy to either go to the WhatsApp group for the parents or to send me a message and reminder of the songs you want us to play during song service. This week our songs are provided to us by the Mudendas. So let's sit back and enjoy the song service.
Calling, come follow me. is good. Wherever we go, from the brightest days to the darkest nights, God is good all the time. Oh, oh, oh. Show the way, we will stand and say that God is good. Oh, oh, oh. Go from the
Welcome back, my friends. I hope we enjoyed our song service. I know we listened to some new songs. Let's make a deal, boys and girls. Let's learn these new songs. Let's sing along and let's learn them so that even next time we meet at church, we'll sing some of these songs. So every week I'm going to put in a new song for us to listen to so that by the time we come to church, whether you come to church next week or you come to church next year, I want you to be able to sing these songs. So thank you to the Mudendas for that wonderful song service. I'll be waiting to hear from the next person from our class who's going to choose our song service. Now let's get into our lesson. It's time for the Bible story. And the title of the Bible story is The Nighttime Visitor. The Nighttime what? Visitor. But before we go into our lesson, let's look at our memory verse. Our memory verse is from 1 John. 1 John chapter 3 verse 1. 1 John chapter 3 verse 1. 1 John is in the New Testament. So get your Bibles, scroll to your Bibles. Here's my Bible, I have my Bible. I hope you have your Bibles. And I'm reading it to you and it says, See what great love the Father has bestowed on us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. I read it again. See what great love the Father has bestowed on us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. Yes, boys and girls, that is what me and you are. We are children of God. Yes, now it's almost time for us to get into the lesson, but our power text, our message for today is God's love changes us. God's love changes us. It changes you. It changes me. It changes the way we behave, the way we act, and how we treat people. It changes our lives. So boys and girls, let's sit back. Let's listen to the story. I'll see you on the other side. And I've got an activity for you. Yes, we have an activity this week. A fun activity. Let's listen to the Bible story. I'll meet you on the other side. Remember, God's love changes us. God's love changes who? You and me. Bye-bye.
Hi everyone, it's Aunt Fernita. Today's story is called The Nighttime Visitor. The memory verse is from 1 John chapter 3, verse 1. It says, See what great love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. Today's message is God's love changes us. When a mother says she's going to change the baby, what does she mean? How is she going to change it? Into what? You know what she means. But what did Jesus mean when he said, you must be born again? Crickets chirped in the grass. Nighttime birds sang. Quietly, Nicodemus walked toward the place where he had heard he could find Jesus. He didn't want anyone else to see him talking to Jesus. When he found Jesus, Nicodemus said, Teacher, we know you came from God. Your miracles tell everybody so. Jesus may have smiled in the darkness. He knew Nicodemus really wanted to believe in him. But Nicodemus was an important Pharisee, a member of the Jewish council. He came to Jesus late at night because he didn't want the other Pharisees to know. Nicodemus knew that Jesus was a teacher sent from God, but he wasn't sure that Jesus could really be God's son. Jesus looked steadily at him. Nicodemus, he said, miracles are not the most important thing. Unless you are born again, you will not see God's kingdom. Born again? What does that mean? I can't go back inside of my mother. I'm a grown man, Nicodemus exclaimed. You're right, my friend, Jesus answered. But I'm not talking about being born physically. I'm talking about being born spiritually. Truthfully, Nicodemus, unless you are reborn by God's Holy Spirit, you can't be part of God's kingdom. I don't understand, Nicodemus said thoughtfully. Think about the wind for a moment, Jesus replied. You can't see the wind itself, but you can see what happens when the wind blows. You can see the treetops sway and hear the rustling of the leaves. When the Holy Spirit comes into a person's life, it's like that. You can't see inside a person's heart, their mind, but you can see what happens in their life because their life is new and clean. Their life is changed. It was quiet as Nicodemus thought about what Jesus was saying. Nicodemus, your physical life came from your parents, Jesus continued. But a person's spiritual life comes from the Holy Spirit. When a person chooses to let God come into his or her life, God helps them change their sinful mind and gives the person a brand new one. That's being born again. Nicodemus, I have good news for you. God loves the world so much that he sent his only son here to save the world. When someone believes in him, God can give them that brand new life. And that new life means you are born again. And those born again will receive the gift of eternal life. Nicodemus learned something that night that everyone must learn. Jesus loves us so much. He is ready right now to take our sinful hearts and lives and give us new ones. Will you let him give you that new, clean heart today? Will you be born again? Will you take the gift of eternal life that he wants to give you? You might want to say something like this to Jesus. Dear Jesus, thank you for loving me. My life is sinful. Right now, I want to give it to you. I ask you to give me a new, clean heart and mind instead. Change my life to be more like yours. Thank you for your gift of eternal life. I love you, Jesus. Amen.
Created and produced by Falvo Fowler. This podcast is read by Franita Buddy Fullwood for gracelink.net. Animation and artwork by Giorgio Godoy. Audio is post-produced by Faith Toh at Studio El Piso in Singapore. The theme music is by Clayton Kinney. The audio engineer was Maurice Bailey.
We learned about Nicodemus talking to Jesus under a tree at night. Remember the title of the story, The Nighttime Visitor. Why did Nicodemus go and visit God at night? In the story, it explains he did not want the people in his city to see him talking to Jesus. Right? So he went to Jesus at night, right? And he went to talk to him in a tree. What did God say to him? He told him that that it's not just about miracles, that you can also become a born-again Christian. Now the word born again, what do you mean born again? Does it mean when I'm born again, I can still go back to being a baby and back into my mother's womb? No. That's not what he meant. He meant when you become born again, you change, your spirit gets rebaptized and you become a Christian, right? That's what it says in the story. Now boys and girls, guess what? I've got an activity that is going to help us illustrate and understand. You know when you have a caterpillar, what do caterpillars turn into? Who can guess? Butterflies, right? So imagine, so just let's take we as we are, with full of sin. We haven't yet repented our sins and been cleansed and been born and been washed and baptized as a caterpillar. So now when we turn from a caterpillar into a beautiful butterfly, we are born again, right? Yes, we are. Remember, the caterpillar becomes a caterpillar. Then from a caterpillar, it changes into a beautiful butterfly. So that is the example we're going to use. I have sent some activities to your parents. They should have printed it for you and cut it out for you so that all you do is you're making a caterpillar and a beautiful butterfly, and you're going to write your memory verse and your power text. Remember, God's love changes us. So the same way the caterpillar changes into a butterfly is the same way our God's love changes us. It makes us into good and better Christians. It helps us change our behavior. It helps us change even in the decisions that we make. So let's say, for example, if I'm not a born again, I am just an ordinary person who's sinful. Then let's say, for example, my little brother, what does he do? He breaks my favorite pencil. What would I do if I was not a Christian or a born again Christian? What would I do? I would beat my brother, right? I would make him pay for what he has done, right? Now, let's imagine after I have transformed into this beautiful butterfly and my brother or sister breaks my favorite lead pencil, what will I do? I will forgive them. I will not be angry with them. I will handle them better and I will treat them nicely. I won't want to beat them or kick them. I will want to just tell them that it's okay. I understand you broke my pencil and I will forgive them. Yes, boys and girls, forgive them. I know how painful it is sometimes to forgive people when they damage something we love. But I will forgive my brother and sisters. So, boys and girls, as we make those beautiful butterflies, I can't wait to see your pictures. Please don't forget to color them, make them colorful and beautiful. And remember that God's love changes us. I'll see you next week, boys and girls. A happy Sabbath and God bless you all. Bye-bye.
Turn to Psalm 139, this is 1 to 3, and it reads, O Lord, you have searched me and you know me. You know my sitting down and my rising up. You understand my thoughts are far off. You comprehend my path and my lying down, and acquainted with all my ways. So we've been talking about it, secret goodness. The primary goal of secret goodness isn't to remain anonymous, but to bring kindness to someone with no strings attached. It is also important to remember that the act of kindness should be motivated by your appreciation of the Father and empowered by His Spirit. If you are grateful for the good things God has done for you, then it is completely reasonable that you will want to live with the same attitude as your Father has, selfless service to others. Being able to reach out to others also who will never thank you or appreciate you personally or publicly is as close to agape, that agape is a God-like love, giving as you can get. You never really understand the life-changing power of secret kindness until you try giving it away. It is one of those experiences you need to do before you have much to say about it. So here today, we've been told that it is good to give secretly and not to want to be praised for it. I'm sure you know people in your lives who like to do things for people and they want to be praised for it. Maybe we have them in our families and maybe amongst our friends, but we are told by God in the Bible, just like I've just read from the Psalms, it says that God knows us, He searches us, and He knows us. He knows when we stand and when we lie down. So God is there watching us, and He appreciates what we are doing. So that is the lesson for today on secret goodness. Happy Sabbath.